Now, for this tutorial, we're going to use a slightly different technique to our previous one. This is going to be cut with galia inserted in. Now, the way we're going to cut this is we're going to use a template of an existing dress to actually cut the outline of this dress. The only difference that we're going to make is I'm going to use this existing dress of mine to actually cut the outline. I will keep the length exactly to this because if you remember in the previous one, I'm going to add a trim at the bottom of it to obviously highlight it and to give it the more of the effect. Now, one of the things that I want to do is I may even make it a little bit shorter because I want to add a sort of a trim at the bottom of it, and I want to keep the darker color, as much of the darker color as possible. So if we're going to add a trim at the bottom of it, I'm going to, because I want to bring the lighter color sort of on the around the waist area. Now, this is going to have a fairly thick border at the bottom of it, so therefore it's going to make it a slightly bit longer than this dress. This dress that I'm using is probably about 42 inches in length, I'm guessing on this, and I will measure it just to think in my own understanding on this as well. I'll lose everything, lose the tape measuring. Right, okay, let's see how good my guesswork was. Right, okay, it's exactly 42 inches, that was just my guess. What I'm going to do is the one that I'm going to make is going to be about 46 inches. So we're going to add an extension off at the bottom here of about 5-6 inches. We'll come to that later on. For the moment, I'm just going to cut this out. Now, as you can see, I've left this wider, and I'm going to actually take this out even further because I'm going to cut this into pieces. And when I cut this into pieces, obviously, I need the allowance for my pieces to be stitched back together. So the outline that we're going to use as an A-line shape to this is this. Cut for the sleeve. And here we're going to cut fairly wide on the shoulder because we're going to cut and bring this in, and then we're just going to mark it out for the neckline. Now here I'm going to mark these as galia, and what I'm doing is I will actually give you the precise dimensions. Now this is the gear of the gamiz. The daman I've cut at 19 inches, so this is folded over, so 19 and 19 is 38 inches in total is the width of this. And then to the waistline, I've trimmed it down, and at the waist, this is 15 inches from the top, the length of the whole of this dress. What I would want you to do is maybe jot these markings down. So the length, the overall length of this dress is 41 inches. From the top of the shoulder, 41 inches, there is a marking on the 15 inch, which is the waistline. And at 15 inches down from the top, I've got this approximately 15 and a half inches from the point, from the turning to the outer line. And I've curved this out going and meeting off at the point. The shoulder area, I've kept this 13 inches, and I've curved this out for the armhole. The armhole length is 7.5 inches, and it's been angled off to make it the rounded effect. Now, from the center, measuring outwards, what you want to do is measure in total is 16 inches here. So if we break this 16 inches down into 4, 8, 12 and 16, and that would give us equal pieces of where we're going to insert the galia. So if you measure these markings down further as well onto the 4 inch markings, 4 8, 12, 16. And now, what I want to actually do is the center. No, scrap that 4-inch one, and I think we're going to go back onto this. I'm trying to work out what's the best way of marking this out. So we have, in total, we have 19 inches. So if we did the first one at 4 inches, and then we've got a seam allowance of 1/2 inch on either side, which leaves it 3. So, yeah, the first one, you want 2 inches, and then you want every 4 inches. 10, 14 and 18. That should be right. So what we've got is 2 inches, 4 inches. Yeah, 2 inches, 4 inches, 4 inches and 4 inches and 4 inches. So in total you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 galia. So we're going to have 5 panels. And you want to mark these out exactly the same on the top as well. 4 and then 6, 10 and 14. These we're going to take down or mark these straight all the way across. And all the way up. My initial one, which was marked as this one, was actually a right one. And then we want the four. Okay. So what you have is equal markings at four inch distance. Now I'm just going to pause here and come back to the second part of this.